Hello and welcome to Dassault Systèmes Executive Insights. I'm Philippe Bardissot. I'm the Vice President for Industrial Equipment at Dassault Systèmes. One of the segments of industrial equipment is agricultural equipment. And joining us virtually today is Thomas Böck, CEO of CLAAS. I had the privilege to work and partner with him for almost a decade. Back then, when tractor and harvester cabins were not yet the high-tech and media centers they are today. We want to discuss three key challenges in the agricultural industry. How to feed the growing world population, the demand for eco-friendly machines, and the trend towards software-driven equipment and system engineering. So let's start, Thomas. Can you tell us a little bit about CLAAS and what you and your company are focusing on from a product and from a service standpoint?
So CLAAS is a family-owned business. It was founded in 1913. And over these more than 100 years, we are pretty successful in developing and producing agriculture machinery, any kinds of combine harvesters, but also forage harvesters, and since almost 20 years, also tractors. And we are also developing services like, for example, IT tools for our end customers, the farmers, in order to allow them to produce food sustainable for the markets they are in.
100 years, wow, what a success story. So the challenges in the agricultural sector must have evolved. Can you tell me what they are today?
Yes, of course. So let's say scarcity of food supply also over the world is one of the challenges we are facing. So we are helping our customers to grow their foods, to distribute it.
Oof, I think we had a little connection issue here, but I can reassure you we understood you perfectly. So moving on, how to feed the ever-growing population is a challenge, particularly with regard to an increased demand to have eco-friendly farming.
Of course, we have sustainability as an issue, also in the view of the climate change, but also in regards of the special conditions in Europe. So we have Green Deal, and that also affects what we are doing. But most of it, we want to deliver products for the end customers using them. And we're looking in all aspects, like, for example, R&D, production, after-sales services, and everything around our products to support the customer.
Yeah, creating a sustainable food supply is clearly an exciting challenge for everyone, especially taking into account that the world's population will rise from 7 to 10 billion people in a couple of years. So Thomas, you also mentioned that you're looking at all aspects when you deliver the products to your customers. And this reminds me of 2016 Hannover Messe, the leading technology fair. CLAAS had a Hey Tedder, ein Heuwender, or ou une faneuse en français, with 10 computer pods around it, showing the life cycle development of the machinery. What was your motivation for putting that amazing display, this booth, together with Dassault Systèmes, and what was the benefit for CLAAS?
So for us, it was very important to really show the connection between all the steps in development till production and after sales service, to understand how data flows from let's say a creation of a product till the end of the life of a product. We wanted to show all the steps in between, all based on the same data source, and show also the process flow in between.
So from A to Z, including after sales service, one of my favorite. Well, this common booth demonstrated one of the things that the Dassault Systèmes team find to be a real key part of any successful digital transformation, strategic partnerships. So, Thomas, what makes a partnership or collaboration successful?
I think, first of all, very important is to have trust and openness, to discuss about topics that lay ahead of somebody, or especially in our collaboration, it is really a strategic approach where we are discussing what lies ahead in the next 3 to 5 years. Try to focus on what can we do with the existing tool chain, but also what needs to be co-developed in the process of changing products on our side, but also developing the next generation of software at the Dassault Systèmes side. So this kind of strategic openness.
Actually, it reminds me about the statement I've seen on your website saying, whenever you need us, we are right there, whatever it takes. This is true for your customers, of course, But I feel like Dassault Systèmes uses it as well, particularly when we talk about our special relationship with CLAAS. Now, Thomas, I got to ask you, how do you see the future of the agricultural industry and the shift towards software and system engineering?
So looking into what we have to do with the sustainability topics, precision farming, as we call it, becomes more and more important. That means we do site-specific farming using GPS technology, auto-steering, also even autonomy assistance systems in our products, in our machinery. And we do, for example, the application of fertilizer or chemicals on the square centimeter. So having this high accuracy while driving in machines that are, let's say, almost 4 meters high and 3 meters 50 wide and more than 10 meters long is quite challenging. So what you have to bring together is all the departments around the product development process, like for example, software engineers, electronics engineers, hydraulic engineers, mechanicals engineers, and all of them together have to have a common approach on the product, no matter where they come from, and really integrating all the dimension of the product is, I think, the biggest challenge, and to do it almost real time at the same time when you have the phases of the product development.
Yes, having a holistic 365-degree view during product development in real time is key, like you said. But 365, there's another 365 that I'd like to talk to you about. Can you tell us more about the importance of 365 Farmnet?
Yeah, so besides all mechanical products, machinery we have a product for a long time, almost 8 years now. It's 365 Farmnet. It's a digital platform we are hosting out of Germany, but globally available, where we do farm management. It's like a organizational tool for the farm to do all the planning, the resource management, the machine planning, and also the application based on the sites we have. We do soil sampling and everything into that, and we allow the customer to optimize his agronomic business using this kind of tools. And therefore, we integrate data from the fields, from satellites, from the weather, but also from all of our connected telematic connected machines in order to give him the insights, and he can make his own decisions, or even we support him with decision-making tools using AI to improve his business.
Indeed, 365 Farmnet is really a wonderful example of a farming value network for either a single farm or maybe in the future a grouping of farms within a region. And it is very inspiring for Dassault Systèmes, showing how we could help companies like CLAAS to not only develop and manufacture agricultural equipment, but also to help innovate entire systems of systems to support complete value networks. Well, we are approaching the end of our wonderful conversation. And when we started, you said that CLAAS had been on the market for more than 100 years. Dassault Systèmes turned 40 recently. Is there anything you would like to say or share with us, Thomas?
Yeah, absolutely. So I congratulate everybody and also Bernard Jalès for the great success over the past 40 years. So you really deserve it. I'm really hoping to follow you and your developments, your inspirations you give us as an industry about what could you do with software and technology to improve our products. So thanks for being with us, and I wish you all the best and all the success you deserve for the next 40 years.
Thank you so much, Thomas.
Thank you very much.
And thank you for watching.